Well, good afternoon and welcome to Mondays with Michael Live here on Facebook. Hope everyone's doing well. Hope everyone had a great weekend. I apologize for not being here last week. We kind of missed the last Monday. Our session was supposed to be on harassment and managers' responsibility to sexual harassment and other forms of harassment. I apologize for not being here. I was actually fairly sick. For those of you who have never gotten vertigo before, I got vertigo last week, and man, it really just knocked me out. The room was spinning, but I wasn't. It was in pretty bad shape for a while, but through some help with some friends and a couple of maneuvers in my head, I'm pretty much back to normal. So for those who've had it, you know exactly what I mean. If you never had it, I just hope you never get it. So our session today is on effective listening skills. So when we work with teams, we work with individuals, this is an employee skill that we get a lot of feedback from our clients that this particular skill is one that is lacking. And a lot of their frontline employees, a lot of folks they were doing recruiting on, they seem to have poor listening skills. So let's talk about that a little bit. Why is that happen? Some tips we're going to give you today on effective listening, some things you may want to try. And then we'll talk about an assessment that we can let you take a look at. We'll offer you a free opportunity to take a look at that assessment to actually measure your listening approach. We'll talk about five different listening approaches. So as always, I'm going to go back and forth with my notes, as I do for all these sessions with Mondays with Michael. So some general information about listening. So listening is both an attitude and a behavior. You have to want to be a good listener, and then you have to behave a certain way to ensure that not only your body language, but your approach to listening is correct in the right situation. So it's both an attitude and a behavior. So first you have to make the commitment to yourself that you want to be a good listener. Some listening facts. 85% of what we learn is through listening. We listen. 45% of what we repeat is from listening. So we also rely on 50% of what is heard is retained. And over a course of a long period of time, only 20% of what we listen to or what we hear is retained. So one of the tips I'm going to give you today, and one of the tips we give in the class, is that carry a notepad around. Write stuff down. I carry a notepad around. It's right here by my desk because I know that only 20% of what I hear is going to be retained over the course of the next few days. So writing stuff down is important. Having some type of system to capture what you're hearing is very, very important. So that's just one tip from you. While we're in the classroom, we talk about the cost of poor listening. The cost of poor listening, by getting the information incorrect the first time, there is a cost to that. And we do this little exercise about a $5 mistake. So if you happen to get some information incorrectly from one of your colleagues, and that information requires you to go back and get that information again, we call that the $5 mistake. If you have three of those mistakes a week, that's $15 a week you cost the company. And if you multiply that by 52 weeks, that's $780 that you've cost your company through these $5 mistakes. Now, if your company has 600 employees, that's $468,000 worth of lost revenue due to that $5 mistake. So there is a cost involved in listening incorrectly, getting the wrong information, or getting information and delivering that information incorrectly to somebody else, that old telephone thing. So it's very, 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 very important that we listen correctly. So in the classroom, we talk about hearing versus listening. Hearing is your ear's ability to naturally attract sound waves from somebody or something. So if I clap my hand, your ear naturally listens. It has that natural effect. Now, that said, some of us are born don't have that ability to listen. But outside of that, if you hear noise around you, your ear does its job. That is the hearing part. Listening is putting meaning to that message. What I call listening is the interactive part of hearing. You have to be engaged. You have to be engaged. And there are things that affect your ability to listen. So in the class, we talk about selective attention, selective interpretation, and selective retention, and those three things will affect the way you listen. And if you're in one of our classrooms, we'll do a deeper dive into one of those areas. But the biggest thing, one of the biggest things we talked about earlier is body language. It's very, very important that you give good body language when you're listening to your colleagues. The first is good eye contact. you really need to have good eye contact. Good eye contact tells you that you're really listening and tells the speaker that they know you're really listening to them because you're focused in. So if you're in your office and you're doing five things at the same time, the phone is ringing, you're doing something on your cell phone, you're watching some email, people know you're not listening. So stop what you're doing, focus in on the person in your office, and really focus in and listen to what they're saying and write it down. So part of this is body language. It's leaning in. It's letting folks know that you're really paying attention by focusing on them, focusing on them. The other thing we teach in the classroom is that you have the ability to speak at 150 words a minute. Some of you remember that FedEx commercial? You have the ability to speak 150 words a minute, but your brain has the ability to listen to 500 words a minute. So what happens in your brain while someone's talking to you is quite interesting, because we have the ability to think of multiple things at the same time. So while one of your employees is talking to you, you could be thinking about the shopping list on the way home. You could be thinking about the NCAA bracket and who you're going to pick in the next round. So your brain has the ability to do two or three things at the same time while your colleague is talking to you. So I encourage you to try not to do that. It's very difficult, but this is practice. Kind of clear your brain out a little bit and focus in on the person that's speaking to you. It's very, very important. So participants who come to our effective listening program take a personal assessment. They actually assess their listening style, similar to DISC, which we do in the classroom, DS&C. In this case, there are five different listening approaches. I'm going to go through them with you just briefly. But at the end of the session today, I'll put a link in the session. You can take a look at a sample report. And if you'd like to take a copy of that personal listening assessment, see where you fall on the map, we're happy to do that for you too. So there are five approaches to listening. The first one is appreciative. So an appreciative listener just enjoys a listening experience. We tend to use this approach when we're sitting in a concert, going to a movie, watching a video online. You just want to enjoy the listening experience. So most of us use this in that environment, using that appreciative listening. The second is empathic. So as an empathic listener, you need to support the speaker, and you need to give them some understanding and focus in on their feelings. Now, we work with a lot of supervisors, and when they take this assessment, they just have a score of less than empathic, and we really, really strongly encourage them that this is an area that you need to work on. There are times you just need to be there for your employees, and it's not just HR that needs to be there for your employees. You as a boss, you as a coworker, you as a team member, just need to be there and listen. And that's that empathic style of listening. The third is discerning. So when we use discerning listening, we're getting the facts. We just want the facts. Just the facts, ma'am. If those of you remember Joe Friday, it was just about the facts. You want to listen to the facts. And in that arena, you definitely want to get all the information. So I always correlate this to, in the classroom, to a police officer going on a crime scene, the who, the what, the when, the why, all of those facts. We use discerning when we want to get the facts of the situation. The fourth is comprehensive. So we want to put meaning behind the transmission, so of the transmission of the person speaking to us. So comprehensive learning, we're trying to put it all together. So team member one is giving me this information. I'm trying to put it in the context with team member number two, me being number three. So comprehensive listening is putting meaning behind the information and trying to put it all together. And the last but not least is evaluative. We use evaluative listening approach where we're being skeptical. So if a salesman's coming into your office and trying to sell you on something, or a team member's giving you information you're not sure about, we use evaluative listening, which is being critical of the information or being skeptical of the information that's coming to you. So those are the five approaches of listening. We offer that as an assessment in our classroom, but I'm going to offer you a free copy of that assessment in the link here in the chat today. And if you want to take that assessment online, you can do that. I do see we have a participant joining us today, our friend and cousin from Italy. Fabio is in the room. Welcome, Fabio. Thank you for joining us today. I really appreciate you coming in the room today. I'm not sure if you're in Italy or Brazil today, but wherever you are, I hope you're traveling safe. So I see it's going up to the top of the 10-minute time, so I'm about to wrap up. So thank you for coming today. We'll see you back next Monday. Next Monday, we'll be back doing leadership work. We're going to do execution of the work of leaders in that model. So thanks for hanging out. See you next week.